really starts with my dad's dream. And when he was in business in Tacoma, he had an older friend from Seattle who knew about the water reclamation that was going to happen in eastern Washington. And before the water came, a great deal of the land was desert. And the Columbia Basin Reclamation Project took place in the 50s, and he thought that Dad should go over there from Tacoma, and he gathered some partners, and they drove over there in their old station wagons, and they found these two towns, and there were wild horses running in the streets, and it was literally dirt streets with wild horses. And they envisioned two small commercial buildings, one in Moses Lake and one in Quincy. In 1954, he built these buildings. When we first thought about this project, to do something in this courtyard, we were renovating the building, we were getting more community-oriented tenants, we were getting the hospital in there with their rehab, and we were getting some other services that were going to help the economy. And we thought it would be really nice to have a special place where not only the people who use the building and who rent there and their customers, but the community could come and spend time. And the courtyard there was just a brick planter with an old tree. And some of the gals would throw a wild bird seed and wildflower seed in there in the summertime and throw some water on it. But I always envisioned something more special. I didn't realize how extraordinary this was going to be, because each of Doug's pieces represents a part of the community. But it's a heartfelt way of giving back, but also setting perhaps a tone for the community, because we are the center of the old town. And it reflects the different parts of the community. There are business people, there's the agricultural, there's a large Hispanic population, and then there's the Microsoft guys and Yahoo guys. And I think that this is going to appeal to a broad spectrum of people. That's what this is about. It's about a little bit of a dream, and my dream in carrying on from my dad's, and to paint the building and to renovate it and bring new people in and to do something extraordinary. And first it was just going to be one sculpture in the center, and now it's turned into a sculpture garden and experience.
Thank you. once in a rare while, I get a chance to do some really spectacular individual pieces, all a part of the same sculpture. And so this is four pieces, and all part of the same piece that's going over to a business courtyard in Quincy, Washington. And so the first piece that's of major mention, I would say, would be this settee. And the settee is made of mosaic chunks of glass, none of which is basically bigger than the face of a sugar cube. And it's filled with 24 karat gold glass that we've made here in the studio. On this side, if one were to look at it, you can see that it's a dish, a bowl that holds the fruits of the Quincy, Eastern Washington area. So this container, the bowl, and then the grape leaves and the apples and the edible grapes, apricots, computer chip, sunflower types, leaves, cherries, onions, which are big over there, potatoes, of course, which are huge, wine grapes, which are huge, wild rose. So you have all of this, the fruits of the Quincy area made possible by the Grand Coulee Dam, which is just great. So then when you come around on this side, so the gold represents the wheat in the fields that are growing up on the tops, and then it folds down over into the Columbia River, which is represented by this dichroic glass. So it's a very, hopefully like the sea itself. Then down here you have the Columbia Gorge and the hills that are all down there. So this whole thing is representative of the Quincy area and a settee. This is the fountain of the Columbia River, and it is a very unusual fountain in that we have all the water running inside of it. So as you step up to it, it sounds a little bit like a mountain brook, a lot like a mountain brook actually. A very soft, gentle, purling sound, a very, very beautiful sound. And then we have, or I have pretended that it's basically all water, even though it's all stone. And we have the salmon running through it, as it were, swimming out of it in areas, running up its little riffles and ripples down in various areas. On the other side here, you can see the salmon swimming directly into the stone with the tails. And on this side, you see them diving down in the waters, riffling along the shallows here. So a very interesting piece. This color that we have on them at the moment is red, just to represent the red salmon. And that's possible we'll change that color, but at the moment we kind of like it. It gives it some interesting character and a little bit of brightness. Kind of goes with the settee, so we like that. The next piece that we have is this piece, which has these big bronze wings that are on it, and they're representing the freedom, the wind, the hawks, the birds of the Columbia Basin. They're representing all that flight means to all of us, flights of fancy. Certainly must have been a flight of fancy when they created Grand Coulee Dam. But these big wings patterned a little bit after the winged victory in the Louvre. They're bronze, and the stone, of course, is basalt, highly carved, highly polished from the Grand Coulee area. The other stone in this suite, then, is this one here. And this stone is called the Unfolding, and it represents like a bean sprout or anything that's growing. So it's just a growing sprout. So on the top, you have this representing the bean sprout or the sprout of any growing plant. Down here, then we have this representing the actual seed that this is growing out of, the germinal part of it. And then the bottom here, which will be painted again in a similar style, but in a darker color, and will be carved to represent the earth. So it's an unusual thing. And on the back here now, we have the sheath that the plant grows out of, and that's represented by these lines.